Good evening. Welcome to the American Institute of Alternative Medicine's 2021 virtual commencement ceremony. We're here to celebrate the academic achievements of a group of students who decided to pursue their dream despite the many challenges brought about by a global pandemic. My name is Melissa Fisher, and I'm the Assistant Director of Education and Student Services. In just a moment, you'll hear me announcing the names of this amazing group of graduates. Before that, AIM's co-founder, Diane Sader-Wee, will start off the ceremony with her opening remarks, followed by welcome messages from campus president, Dr. Relyn Ernest, and our academic dean, Dr. Elaine Hyatt. I hope you enjoy this ceremony, and congratulations, graduates.
Hi, I'm Diane Sader-Wee. I'm the CEO here and co-founder at American Institute of Alternative Medicine. I'd like to congratulate you on getting here to graduation. It took a lot of effort. You put a lot of work in. You made a lot of sacrifices. And here you are, ready to enter a healing profession. Our mission is transforming healthcare holistically. You will always be part of the American Institute of Alternative Medicine, AIM family. And I hope that you touch people, many, many people, with healing and loving touch, and help them with their health and help to transform our healthcare. Congratulations.
It is my great pleasure this evening to welcome you to the American Institute of Alternative Medicine's commencement ceremony. Students, you have long anticipated this day, some with eagerness, some with anxiety, some with a complicated mix of emotions. But whatever you are feeling here today, you deserve to hold a keen sense of pride. You did this. This is a major step in the journey of your lives, one that should be recognized for its immense significance. It is an act not only of personal commitment, but also one of pride. You have all worked hard to get to this day, and your work did not go to waste. Certainly, all those gathered here today to celebrate with you have a tremendous sense of pride in you. One other group taking great pleasure in today's events are the staff and faculty at the American Institute of Alternative Medicine. I work with this group of instructors and staff closely, and I know firsthand the great satisfaction and pride they feel in the accomplishment of today's graduates. But graduation is not an end goal in itself. It is instead a part of the larger journey of life. Wherever your future takes you, let it take you somewhere. Your graduation should serve as a launching point, projecting you to wherever your futures are meant to take you, whether it be a new career, a new degree, or perhaps even ending back here at AIAM to teach and guide a new generation of students. In closing, welcome to tonight's graduation ceremony. And congratulations on your journey.
Greetings, faculty, staff, family, friends, and graduates. Arriving here today represents a significant achievement for each of you. We are honored to have been a small part of your life's journey as the school you chose to earn your academic award, which will allow you to achieve your career goals. Students in all our programs have much to learn, even new terminology and ways of thinking. Additionally, the online learning environment for many of your classes was new for most of you and created the need for adapting to new methods of learning. You did this, even though there were many bumps and learning opportunities along the way. This adaptability in achieving your academic success speaks to your resiliency, persistence, and determination. Qualities that will sustain you in your career and in your life. The combination of virtual classes and on-campus skills classes have afforded many the ability to attend school when all on campus would have been more difficult for your life circumstances. Still, this hybrid education came with its own challenges, which you met and overcame to bring you to where you are today. When you face challenges in your life, as we all do, remind yourself what you accomplished over the past year, or more for some of you, and that you can do anything. I know that all of us at AIAM hold a vision of your success, and please know, we are so proud of you. Your contributions to the wellness of our community in the years to come will make a difference in this world. You did it, graduates. Congrats.
And now, the ceremony for graduates in the acupuncture program begins with a message from Program Chair Dr. Chen.
Congratulations to the class of 2021. In these extraordinary times, AIM has graduated a class of extraordinary students. The COVID-19 pandemic has challenged us all, both in and outside the classroom. I applaud the resilience and adaptability shown by each and every one of you. I also would like to thank you all for the patience and understanding as we grew together throughout the past year. I so wish I could personally hand you your hard-earned degree today on stage at graduation, but even virtually, I want you all to know how proud I am of the diligence and the perseverance that has brought you all today. The world needs people like you, so go out there and help those in need. Thank you.
I now present to you graduates who have earned the degree Master of Acupuncture. Christine Fumia, Deirdre Wong, Erica Niewald, Christopher Stevens, Michelle Stobart, Ashley Marchek Vieson, congratulations, graduates. We wish you all the very best. And now, the ceremony for graduates in the Western Massage Therapy Program begins with a message from Program Coordinator Jane Kalu.
Welcome, graduates. While not the graduation we envisioned or hoped for, it is still important to take a moment to come together to acknowledge all your hard work and effort. I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge that we all still have been experiencing the hardships of dealing with the pandemic and all its variants. You may have caught the coronavirus and had to directly deal with it yourself. For some of us, we may have lost a loved one, a family member, or a friend to this virus. Everyone has had to scramble to make sense of the scope of this pandemic and adjust accordingly. In addition, you decided to go to school. So as a student, you've had to learn how to balance your work life, your home life, your school life. In school, some of you had to learn how to study again, how to take notes, how to do homework, how to take tests. For some of your classes, you've had to learn how to be tech savvy, to take these tests and submit assignments online. You've had to figure out how to maneuver the Zoom classroom while still staying motivated and engaged. On the upside of some of these online classes, your family pets have probably greatly appreciated the additional cuddle time because you're at home. Some have even tried to attend classes with you, usually appearing on the screen at inopportune moments, but they made us smile. Probably the best part of being in the massage program is that you've had classes on how to give a massage, which means you also had to receive a massage frequently, and it counts for credit. Despite some of these challenges, you did it. You made it through the massage therapy program and are graduating. So I offer both my congratulations and my admiration on a job well done. Despite all the obstacles, you made it through school and now have the opportunity to fulfill your goal to become a licensed massage therapist. What I encourage you to do is don't stop there. Keep your heart and mind open to new opportunities. You never know where they could lead. I also challenge you to never lose your thirst for knowledge. Take classes online, attend webinars, get together with other therapists and share ideas and techniques. You can even have your own Zoom sessions. It will allow you to grow as a professional and it'll allow you to better care for your clients. One of the things I love about being a teacher is that I'm involved in a profession of lifelong learning. Not only do I learn from reading and webinars and in-service classes, but I learn from all of you. I especially like when a student asks me a question that I don't know the answer to, which for me is exciting because it means I'm going to learn something new. This new knowledge I then can pass forward to the next group of students. And for that, I thank you. I also appreciate the perspective that you all as students shared with me. I love those moments as well. I can't tell you how many times a student would present a different perspective of a topic, and I'd think, never thought of it that way. I'm going to borrow that, use it in my future classes. Thank you for the discussions, the learning moments, the Google searches, and the laughs, and of course, playing cahoots. Thank you for sharing a part of yourselves and helping me to become the best teacher I can be. As you move on from your time here at AIM, please take a moment now and then to keep in touch with your teachers. Just say hello or share an experience or even consult us as a reference. We very much want to hear how you're doing and to hear your stories. We are invested in your success. In closing, remember, we will be here for you if you need us and we'll leave the light on. Congratulations, graduates.
I now present to you the graduates who have earned the degree Western Massage Therapy Diploma. Hannah Ash. Megan Faye Benchwick. Stephanie Clark. Audrey Eccles. Brandy Flieger. John Crum. Kara Lee Lee. Madison Matthews. Kendra Polly. Aubrey Reams. Austin Roberts. Abigail Stump. Kaylin Times. Amber Wolf. Edwin Wooliver. Congratulations, graduates. We wish you all the very best. I now present to you our graduate who earned the degree, Medical Assisting Diploma. Londa Jennings.
Congratulations, Londa. We wish you every success in your medical assisting career.
And now, the ceremony for graduates in the practical nursing and registered nursing programs begins with a message from Director of Nursing, Dr. Pam Frost.
Congratulations, graduates. I am Dr. Pam Frost, the Director of Nursing at AIAM. The past year has been challenging for all of us, personally and academically. The pandemic made all of us change how we lived, worked, and how administration and faculty delivered education, but more importantly, how you learned. You had to adapt to a distance education, which put even more stress on earning your nursing degree. You are here today because you persevered, worked through all of the changes in education, changes in your personal life, and you never quit. You kept your eyes on your goal of becoming a nurse. You and your family should be proud of the enormous challenges you faced to be sitting here today, graduating from the nursing program. Again, congratulations. One of the traditions of all nursing students is to recite the Nursing Declaration. It is an affirmation that you have become a full-fledged nurse and is a promise to your patients and colleagues that you will deliver care with honesty, integrity, and present of your patients at all times. Now, graduates, please stand in place wherever you are and recite the pledge virtually with me. We, the nurses and concerned citizens of the global community, hereby dedicate ourselves to achieve a healthy world. We declare our willingness to unite in a program of action, to share information and solutions, and to improve health conditions for all humanity, locally, nationally, and globally. We further resolve to adopt personal practices and to implement public policies in our communities and nations, making this goal achievable and inevitable, beginning today in our own lives and in the lives of our nations and in the world at large. Again, congratulations, graduates, and I wish you the best in the future.
I now present to you the graduates who have earned the degree Practical Nursing Diploma. Imelda Achu. Vincent Yaboa Adu. Ashley Asamwa. Juliet Asamwa. Adele Atencham. Cynthia Atsoleke. Nathalia Bienname. Rita Botang. Marion Bundu. Ibrahim Karu. Abrima Conte. Zainabu Conte. Jamia Cunningham. Alexandra Dudonet. Renee Bell Emethue. Christiana Emerson. Minette Epede. Dorothy Eong. Teresa Fatorma. Kimberly Gilbert. Samantha Gilbert. Kadijatu Jallo. Lucian Jallo. Luceline Joseph. Ian Kane Callan. Joseph Kamara. Mabinti Kamara. Mariama Kamara. Matina Kamara. Linda Kangmani. James Tina Kenu. Rashid Kenu. Wendy Kijang. Agnes Kortu. Fatmata Kuroma. Levert Kungang. Monica Kuzilwa. Aminata Laga. Floris Laga. Rosemary Laga. Grace Lisa. Deidre Lyles. Adama Monserrat. Madusu Mansere. Sarah Martia. Justine Vando. Cyril Bata. Vivian Mensa. Chiameka Maname Wilkerson. Angelina Mua. Ngazi Nana. Destine Demanu. Chanceline Njo. Moyatu Ngebe. Jonathan Nimne Dixon. Donatus and Kamalem. Nadej Nkangathak. Martin Nkong. Adesua Okonofua. Bridget Oluwatoyin Ayodele. Franklin Ose Bonsu.
Jessica Parker. Gum Pentifa. Stanley Raymond. Nemo Salah. Adonis Sam. Hawanatu Sanko. Lakezia Sears. Alhaji Sise. Armanda Saina Naj. Marie Soare. Brenda Tabe. Rujiatu Taylor Kamara. Haja Timbo. Nina Timo. Mbalu Toure. Sarah Toure. Ayan Warsama. Fidelia Wyafi. Melrose Williams. Simeon Yankuba. Congratulations, graduates. We wish you all the very best. I now present to you the graduates who have earned the degree Associate of Applied Science, Registered Nursing. Faria Abdi. Anita Badu. Ama Botang Asante. Felix Botchway. Fatuma Boulay. Suad Boulay. Tracy Darbo. Haja Diallo. Kendea El Belali. Joy Ene. Fatmata Fofana. Stephanie Gonzalez. Tamika Hester. Jamilo Issy. Adama Kamara. Fatmata Kamara. Josephine Kanu. Judith Kaimain. Aisatu Kuyate. Shiloh Lahey. Tibet love. Lynn Maritime. Nasra Mohammed. Francis Moore. Naimo Muse. Merlene Nwankwo. Uzoma Nwankwo Njoku. Asho Omar. Olubunkola Orisotu. Jane Sanders. Ilhan Talim. Natasha Williamson. Congratulations, graduates. We wish you all the very best. And now for the conferral of degrees with Academic Dean Dr. Hyatt and Campus President Dr. Ernest.
Dr. Ernest, I hereby certify that the graduates before you have completed all the necessary requirements for graduation.
Upon recommendation of the Academic Dean, Dr. Hyatt, and by the power and authority entrusted to me by the State of Ohio and the Accrediting Commission for Career Schools and Colleges, graduates, I hereby confer upon you the degree with appropriate honors, privileges, and responsibilities in which you have earned. Congratulations to our AIAM graduates.
Thank you for joining us this evening. We hope you've enjoyed this presentation. We wish all of our graduates the very best.